بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Hello everybody, I am Professor حسام الفلال from منصورة University, Egypt. Our subject today is optimizing clear corneal phaco incision. Why wound construction is essential? Because a well-constructed wound improves fluidics and anterior chamber stability during phacoemulsification. Also, it helps the self-sealing of the wound and the post-operative healing with minimal induced astigmatism. What are the essentials for a good wound construction? Number one, create the tunnel on a normally pressurized globe. Avoid high intraocular pressure as it yields a short tunnel. Also, soft eyes yield a longer than expected corneal tunnel. Number two, for a precise control of your keratome, always stabilize the globe. This stabilization can be achieved with a forceps, with a fixation ring, with your fingers, and so on. Number three, the blade should be sharp. Avoid dull diamond blade or reuse of metal blades. These dull blades yield an uncontrolled irregular wounds with subsequent poor wound stability. Where should be the entry point? The entry point should be just anterior to the conjunctival insertion in front of the limbal vascular arcade. Keep peripheral as much as you can. Why? Being near the vascularized limbus, the wound heals rapidly. Also, to be away from the optical center of the cornea, hence the resultant surgically induced astigmatism will be minimal. However, some surgeons prefer to move 0.5 mm near the limbus to get a more better wound healing. This is called near clear cornea incision. A more central incision is required in large corneas and high myopic eyes for easier phaco tip manipulation. Also, central wounds are needed in small pupil and in IFS cases to prevent iris prolapse during surgery. On the contrary, a peripheral incision is preferred in eyes with small corneas, shallow anterior chamber, and hyperopic eyes. This minimized surgically induced astigmatism. Regarding incision placement, the incision can be constructed anywhere on the cornea. If you are planning for astigmatic control, place your wound on the steepest K reading. There is a good agreement that the temporal incision is better, especially in deep-seated eyes and the surgery under topical anesthesia, as this approach improves the lid reflex. What about the width? The width of the incision is mainly governed by the phaco tip diameter, either a standard needle or a micro tip. However, some BSS leak around the needle are helpful in cooling the needle, hence minimizing wound burn. On the other hand, a relatively tight wound may be needed in eyes with shallow anterior chamber. Regarding the length of the incision, to get a watertight or water self-sealing incision, the incision should be square or nearly square shaped. That's to say, the length of the incision equal its width. This is difficult in large wounds. So, for a self-sealing wound, the length of the incision should be 1.75 mm. Anyhow, avoid too long tunnel as it causes corneal distortion, and avoid also too short tunnels as it is leaky and may induce excessive iris prolapse during surgery. The style or the internal contour of the incision outlines the pathway of the keratom into the clear cornea, from its entry point on the corneal epithelium till the full keratom entry into the anterior chamber. This pathway is either single plane or stab-like configuration, like in figure A, and this is the least stable incision. Multiplanar configuration, which is either two-step or three-step as in figure B and C respectively. This is the commonly used incision. The keratom tip enters the cornea with the heel of the keratom is slightly elevated. Then the keratom is tangentially passed for about 2 millimeters parallel to the cornea. Then elevate the keratom heel up again to enter the anterior chamber. This is a three-step pathway. In the two-step or biplanar or shallow groove incision, a shallow vertical groove about 0.3 millimeters is made into the cornea. Then the keratom is passed tangentially for 1.5 to 2 millimeters before entry into the anterior chamber. The rationale here is to create a thick outer lip that can resist tearing, hence a better wound stability. The three-step or deep groove or three-planar incision. A deep vertical groove, 80 to 90% of the corneal thickness is created, and the keratom passes in the middle of this groove to create the tangential element of the incision before entry into the anterior chamber. The rationale here is to create a hinge that can resist wound deformation on external pressure. So, this incision is called hinged incision. To conclude, to get a watertight incision, it should be multiplanar, either with the external wound lip grooved or beveled. Wound closure. Wound closure is achieved via stromal hydration. This hydration causes apposition of the wound roof and floor. Then the hydrostatic forces of the corneal endothelial bump will help seal the incision. Hydration should be gentle using 27 gauge cannula. At the end of the operation, always ensure the eye is well formed. You can feel the intraocular pressure digitally with your index finger. This video demonstrates stromal hydration. It is better to hydrate the main incision directly after intraocular lens implantation and before viscoelastic removal. It is easier and the anterior chamber is more stable. How can you improve stromal hydration? This can be done using wound hydration bucket. Prior to creating the clear corneal incision, make a 0.5 mm supra-incisional stromal bucket anterior to the intended entrance. The bucket thickness is one-third of the stromal thickness. Hydrate the bucket at the end of the operation. This bucket hydration pushes the roof of the wound against its floor, which itself is pushed forward by the intraocular pressure. Thus, good wound apposition is achieved. Hydration bucket can be done late in the operation if needed. In this case, after usual hydration, the wound is still leaky. So, I perform a bucket and hydrate again to achieve a good seal. Now this is a good seal. To ensure a watertight closure, some advocate using Seidel test. I use sterile corticosteroid eye drops in a suspension form to examine for wound closure. In some cases, wound stromal hydration is not sufficient to secure a watertight closure. The commonest cause is improper wound construction. However, with proper wound construction, fluid leak continues in these cases, as in cases of pterygia, corneal scars, and elderly patients. If the wound is unstable, don't hesitate to take a suture. Suture is not a shame. What about the sideboard incisions? They give an access route for the secondary instrument and for intracameral injection. Place the sideboards in your comfortable position for bimanual handling. The proper size of the sideboards should be 1 millimeter. During creation of the sideboards, keep the aqueous from escaping out of the anterior chamber to maintain a pressurized glue. Otherwise, inject viscoelastic. Thank you. Waiting you in the next lecture.